This may look like someone controlling a virtual quadcopter in a video game. But actually what's happening is this is a person with paralysis who has a brain-computer interface who's controlling it with their thoughts.
A brain-computer interface, just like it sounds, is a way that your brain can communicate with a computer. The brain uses electrical signals from the neurons to control everything we do, everything we move, how we speak, how we think, how we feel. A brain-computer interface, a BCI, takes these signals by recording them through small electrodes and uses them, analyzing them, in order to produce useful things.
A brain-computer interface can control a wide variety of types of devices. They can be anything from computers, from robotic arms, or even potentially somebody's own hand. And you have research labs like ours and others that are looking in how to use artificial intelligence and advanced algorithm design to extract information from the brain in a reliable way, and they can be deployed in someone's home, and somebody's caregiver or the person themselves can turn them on and start using them.
The procedure that we're doing for this particular patient is removal of a portion of the brain that's causing seizures. Prior to removing that area of the brain that's causing the epilepsy, we're placing a chip temporarily on the area of the brain that we're going to be removing.
This is the first implantation of the Connexus Brain-Computer Interface by Paradromics into a human participant. The chip has over 400 tiny sensors attached to the bottom side of it, and these can be implanted into the brain, and then the signal can be extracted from the electrodes through the chip and output to a device that communicates with the computer. With this technology, we're able to record information from the brain in a way that we haven't been able to record it before. We're hoping to learn how this region of the brain is affected in people with epilepsy, and that may allow us to better tailor our surgeries and other therapies for these people to better treat their disease.
This technology is all coming together now to revolutionize our understanding of brain function, but it also provides us with an avenue to help restore function to people who have lost it either through an injury or through some condition.
What we're working on right now may eventually allow for either replacement or restoration of their motor function many years down the road.
My goal is to be able to, in my lifetime, see patients with neurological diseases that can't be treated and offer them brain-computer interfaces that they can then take home and use for real life.
The role of research and technology in neurosurgery is absolutely essential. It's the lifeblood of our department, and it's why people want to come to the University of Michigan to get their care, because they know that we are always trying to push the field forward.
Dr. Willsey's ability to assemble this team and accomplish this feat more than anything embodies our mission and vision to deliver outstanding care, but equally importantly, to contribute to a better tomorrow for our patients.